Welcome to a lesson on the circumference of a circle. The distance around a circle has a special name called the circumference. So we can think of the circumference of a circle as the perimeter of a circle. To find the circumference of a circle, we use one of the two formulas. The two formulas are equivalent. First, we have the formula C equals 2 times pi times r, where C is the circumference and r is the radius. And because 2 times the radius is equal to the diameter, we can also give the circumference formula as C equals pi times d. In the formula, this symbol is pronounced pi and is defined as the circumference of any circle divided by its diameter. So pi is equal to the circumference divided by the diameter for any size circle. For example, if we consider this circle here, if we determine the circumference, which is the distance around the circle, and divided by the diameter, this will give us the value of pi. We often replace pi with the approximate value of 3.14 or 22 sevenths. Let's look at two examples. We're asked to find the circumference of each of the following circles, leave the answer first in exact form, meaning leave the pi in the circumference, and then in rounded form to the hundredths place value, which means two decimal places. So looking at the first circle, notice how we're given the radius r is equal to 4 inches, and therefore we will use the circumference formula C equals 2 times pi times r. And now we substitute 4 inches for r. Sometimes we'll leave the units off until we determine this product, but I'm going to go ahead and include the units this time. So we'll say the circumference C is equal to 2 times pi times 4 inches. And because 2 times 4 is equal to 8, the exact circumference is 8 pi inches. And now we'll use a calculator and get our decimal approximation for the circumference to the hundredths place value. Many calculators have a pi button, so if we use the pi button instead of the approximate value of 3.14 for pi, it will affect our rounded results. Let's go ahead and show both. Using the pi button, we would have 8, and then pi is second in the exponent key, enter, to the hundredths place value. This is approximately 25.13 inches. Using the pi button is more accurate than using 3.14, so let's do a comparison. If we enter 8 times 3.14, notice how we get the approximate value of 25.12, which is slightly different than when we get when we use the pi key, because the pi key uses a better approximation for pi. Now for our second example, notice how we're given the diameter, and therefore this time we'll use the formula C equals pi times d. So we substitute 12.44 for the diameter, so we have C equals pi times 12.44 meters, and therefore the exact circumference is 12.44 pi meters. And now we'll go back to the calculator and get our decimal approximation for the circumference. And again, we will compare the values using the pi button versus using 3.14. Using the pi button, we'd have 12.44 times pi, enter, which would be approximately 39.08 meters. And if we enter 12.44 times 3.14, notice how we get approximately 39.06. I'm going to use a more accurate approximation of 39.08. But if your directions do say use 3.14 for pi, make sure that's what you enter on your calculator. I hope you found this helpful.